Hi, folks. So, we have a bit of a different evening planned for this evening. It's not a particularly long evening. First of all, you might notice the chat has been moved into the bottom left, and I think I've fixed some of the problems with it by hacking with the CSS coding. It's out of the way of the game. It covers the map up a little bit, but you can see the middle of the map. So, we'll see how it goes. I'm sure it'll upset somebody. So, anyway, the plan is, this is a Steam controller special. Step-by-step gamer, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. So that's this thing here. I did a thing on this over the Children in Need 24-hour special, but I didn't actually really use it in any particular earnest. So I thought I would... brain's just not working tonight. So I thought I'd actually spend the whole evening doing some scenarios. And what I've done is I've picked scenarios you wouldn't want to run in a control on the Xbox controller in a million years. Oblob123, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. The sync is out of whack. What's the sync is out? How is everyone? How's the audio for everybody? Tell me how the audio is, folks. Are we all okay? Is it worth going on? There's only one person complained, so... I bet Steam paid Matt for this. No. Audio is fine. Good, right, we'll carry on then. Excellent. Right, so, I'm going to be... No, Steam haven't paid me to do this. I just happen to think this is blindingly good controller. And Ed, who is Dominus Awardius on there, who is also the brains behind the complexity that is the mesh tools, things like the Jinty and so forth, who was telling me, well, that won't work, and this won't work, and yeah, they all worked. So so the Jinty, for example, worked beautifully on this controller. Right, why are all the names yellow? Because I couldn't, because otherwise they were all different colours, which would mean you'd get really bad colouring and things like that. Hey there, KTUK, welcome. Right, you want blue. Well, you can't have blue. So, blah. Darkness Monster likes it. There you go. So anyway, getting back to the topic at hand. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off by just doing the first scenario, and then before we do the subsequent, the two other scenarios, they're about half an hour each. Scan you 144, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. I'm not expecting massive followers to new people watching the stream tonight, given that American Truck Simulator came out, and that looks pretty cool. But we're not doing too bad, over 100 already. So, wow. Everyone wants their own colour. Yeah, but then everyone says, oh, I can't read it. RubQ got 995 in this scenario. Well, according to the screen, you did. Right, so yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run one scenario, and I'm just going to get on with it. I'm going to use the controller. Then I'm going to go through the setup of the controller so you can see what it can actually do. And then we'll run two more scenarios, which will challenge things a little bit. Right, okay, so first things first, you'll notice that unlike, Coproper Mal, thanks for the host, and Rubku, I think you hosted earlier on, anybody else who played, who hosted earlier on, much appreciated. Yeah, you'll notice that unlike the Xbox controller, I actually have a mouse pointer. So, let me use the mouse pointer, which makes just navigating this user interface so much nicer. So let's get going. X-Shooter, thank you for the host. Host ray type. You make it, you flash it up on the top of the screen, and everyone wants to do it. Amarillum wants alternating pink and yellow letters. I'll consider it. Neo Striker, thank you for the host. Victor, thank you for the host. So I'm going to bring the game audio. Oh no, I'm not going to wait for the game to. Mouse pointer using a joypad. Witchcraft. It is, Moggy. It is. This controller is utter witchcraft. It really is. It really is total and utter witchcraft. Hopefully you can hear everything. You can hear me okay. Right, car. Thank you for the host. all these hosts are going to make your stream famous. Yeah, if there's any here with zero viewers. So Fringe Styling, I watched the video, it's very good. For those that want to see it, pop over onto the Train Sim Life Facebook page. It's on the post of the Facebook. Ed, how much is the Steam controller? I think it's about $39.99, something along those lines. You buy it, you can get it in game, you can buy it directly or online through Steam. It's a wicked bit of kit, it really is. And I'm not going to be demonstrating one of my favourite features in it, because it doesn't really make any sense for Train Sim, in that there's a gyro in this thing. So for Flight Sim, or for driving games, you drive them, you know, by turning it like a steering wheel. Fishing, you cast the rod by doing that. Flight Sim, you use it like a yoke. You know, it's amazing. Right, continuing the All Stations 2 graphing service. This part of the journey takes us between Munich East, where the passengers have already boarded, and graphing department ready. Right, now I have set this up to switch on PZB and CIFA, but it's not working. So I need to figure that out later. So I'm going to turn it on the old-fashioned way. And what we got here? We want to put some wipers on, don't we? Let's get some wipers on, because I've forgotten what button I mapped for the wipers, doing it the other way. Right, we need to put it in forwards and get going. Right. I'm going to explain all of this in a minute. Free out from PZB. Now, I'm not going to be looking at chat for the moment, folks. So if you have any questions, hold them until I do the next sort of more interactive session after this scenario. This really is just a guide, a sort of an introduction. And this menu here is done by Steam. It's not part of the game, it's done by Steam. And it's a menu that I set up. My profile is public. You can get my profile. One of the reasons that I can't really pay attention to the chat is because in order to show you this, I've got to stream the monitor and not the actual game window itself. And by streaming the game window, it means if I put the chat where I normally do it, it gets you can see it on the stream, and it just looks really messy than usual. So again, I pop that up. I've got the mouse pointer, and I can just use the mouse pointer to get what I want. I mean, I'm just doing the mouse pointer. Consider it like a wheel almost. I'll get to go again in a minute. This is a nice combined handle train. You're constantly looking to. I know it's. Let me try and. How's that? That's a bit more comfortable. I'm actually leaning back in the chair as well, because one of the good things about controllers is you can lean back. It's called lean back gaming. 60 limit as we come through here. GWR, thank you for the host. Much appreciated. I'm just using the A key to acknowledge CIFA, because it works, why not? Stand on the brakes as we come into here. We might never worth this. Oh no, we're actually going to overshoot. Brakes on this thing are stormingly good. Oblivious, I'm on the big TV now, am I? Fantastic. I need to be on the big TV. Right, let's go and acknowledge the debris up there and clear that, so get the next one done. So, over here I've got a selection of functionality, like I've got the headlights. So if I go to the front, and then over here I can operate the headlights. There you go, I've got the headlights set up. Get back in the cab. Cab light. Instrument lights, there we go, we've got instrument lights, let's use those. So these are the two I've set up for toggling PZB and CIFA, but they don't work for some reason on this train. AWS and DSD CIFA, I've got them set up on here. Bethel 40, PZB 3 and PZB ACK are in this trio here. You can put icons in there, I just haven't done it yet. I haven't really mastered what I want to do for those yet. You can put icons, which will make it a lot easier to do. I'm trying to keep it to where you can see what I'm doing with the controller. Has anyone got the oops. Why did that go off? It wasn't in restricted monitoring. Darn it. I was still in 1000 Hz, wasn't I? Twit. Getting all excitable. Get ready to acknowledge this one. Add coal. Yeah, you're right. That's what I need to do. Oh, no, don't need to. Right, let's speed up. We've got 2 kilometres now to Trudering. Okay, the emergency just came on again. I don't know what's going on. Someone tell me what I'm doing wrong. Because I don't know what I did wrong there. Hey there, Fluky Harry. Ah, now we're in restricted monitoring. And I can't free that, so I'm going to leave it at 14. But no, oh, PZB challenge, yeah, really. That's the guy behind me, yeah, really. Acknowledge that PZB. So you can't do things with PZB with the Xbox controller. Oops. Speeding. Never mind. Never mind, we're almost in Trudering. P should be from 10, you should make the rest up. Failed on the hill in part 2 of Durham to Middleton. Yeah, I think that's where I fail. I stopped. Okay, we're not going to get a great score on this one. But that's fine. I'm still not entirely comfortable with the setup on this yet, but I'm getting there. I just need to use it some more, get some more practice with it. Better get doors open. All right, we've got 500. Oh, did we have 500 hertz monitoring? That's what tripped us up the last time, and then it's all just gone downhill since then. Well, that would explain a lot, actually. Don't want that. Get off that. All I have to do, by the way, is touch the sensor for that to happen. I'm not clicking anything, I'm just touching it. Right. 500 hertz, so we're at 25 kilometers per hour restriction until we get out of that. You can't escape from 500 hertz. When I say Steam controller is better than the keyboard, it depends really. I mean, if what you want is to be able to sit back and use a controller, then the Steam controller is better than the Xbox controller, without a shadow of a doubt, for what we're doing here. Because you can access so much more functionality. Whereas, come on, out of 500 hertz, be all day. Is it better than the keyboard? If you're used to the keyboard and prefer the keyboard, then possibly not. The nice thing about this is that you can sit back and you can use it on... Oh, we've come out of monitoring. Off we go. So you can use it on things like the Steam Link box or on your television, things like that, if you are that kind of way inclined. I've always liked playing the game with the Xbox controller, but the downside is there's just so much functionality that you're missing on the Xbox controller that it just sort of ruins it for me, frankly. Because I want to play trains like this, I want to play trains like, well, all the trains I'm playing tonight, which you can't play on the Xbox controller, except the last one, you probably can. Maximum speed posted. I wonder if this thing. What's the maximum speed of this thing? A chicken onesie. Oh, what? I don't even know what's going on with this conversation. Do I want to know? Keyboard and rail driver. Yeah, this doesn't replace the rail driver. Absolutely doesn't replace the rail driver. If you've got a rail driver, this is a non-starter. But if you haven't got a rail driver, it's a controller. It's a step forward, and it's a hell of a lot cheaper than a rail driver. Okay, well, I've been nowhere near 140, so it's not been the overspeed that's been kicking me out. Right, Gronsdorf. Did I see the new wagon packs from Virtual Road? I did, and they look splendid behind some of the older German stock, like the BR86 and the other steam engine I can't remember the name of, embarrassing. Right, we're not in restricted monitoring or anything. Steve's never used his rail driver, he just prefers the keyboard. That's heresy. Rail driver greater than keyboard. Yes, DJ Techno. If the Steam controller is an excellent controller. So if you need a controller for anything, then I definitely recommend it. It's brilliant. Especially with a gyro. Like I say, if you're playing driving games, you can do this. It's really cool. think the pads are too big and prefer thumbsticks. Have you tried it, BMJ Epic? I would recommend you try and find a way to try it, because I thought similar, but I wasn't entirely sure. And when I tried it, it was absolutely fine. It takes a bit getting used to, because you haven't got anything physical that you're pushing against like you do. But you just get used to it. It really is just a question of getting used to it. It's a different way of doing it. Yellow is coming up. Expect to stop on the starter out of par. My profile for Train Sim did seem to be on there, because I downloaded it onto this machine. The fishing one had gone away, and I have had to restart remaking it, so I've been doing that this afternoon. But the Train Sim one seemed to be there, but I shall republish this one, because I've modified this one so that it works better with some of the advanced steam engines, so you've got a better way of doing the reversal lock and things like that. Which wasn't catered for in the last controller profile I did. Right, getting lots of Skype messages popping up. Is there any problem with sharing my monitor? Open, yeah, that's better. Of course, the other thing you've got, which is quite nice, is you've got, you know, the usual benefits from having a controller for cinematics and cameras and all that sort of thing. You've got quite nice control over it, as you do with the Xbox controller. We get score. What's going on here? We're not getting good score. 500 hertz again, so 25 kmh until we get released. Right, we've come out of 500 hertz. I should be able to release from that. No. Speed up. Can't remember what to. 45 apparently. Do they feel anything like using a touchscreen? No, they're quite. They've got a nice feedback, and they've also got the haptic feedback on them as well. Right. Right, we're in restriction 45. But the last signal was green, so off we go. Better than any telly, yeah, you've been framed. Right, that's my top speeding up. Alright, once I finish this scenario, I'll try and take a look at that, Steve. Vatterstetten. If anyone would like any more German words destroyed, just let me know. I don't charge. that. How caught am I up am I on uploading streams to YouTube? Not very. The problem is every day I upload a few and I record a few more, so at the best I generally tread water. How good is it playing games like Call of Duty? I understand it's good for it. I don't play those kinds of games on the PC, so I am the wrong person to ask that. I play flight sim, fishing, train sim, truck sim, those kinds of games, and it's great for those. I understand it's very good for... I mean, Steve Valve made it. They would have made it work well with all of their games, so Counter-Strike, CSGO, and so forth. The stories I've read are that it's good. But like I said, it's not something that I've played with. The customization of it means that you can tailor all sorts of things, which are really clever. I'm going to show you that in a minute. Still got an 85, so we're good to just gun it. 120 out of the station. Voldem. Have I played any American Truck Sim? I don't have American Truck Sim yet, I'm afraid. I bought a copy for camera. Would anyone like to wager a guess as to whether he's sitting up there playing it now or whether he's gone to bed like he was supposed to? There you go, Steve says it's really good for first person shooters. That's certainly what I'd heard. Boredom, yeah, it's where I come from, isn't it? Self-troll. Right. Stop. Just having a controller with a mouse is phenomenal. Can you have Train Sim installed on a network disk with a 1 gig connection over work? Well, if it accesses like a normal drive, I don't see why. Yeah, DJ Techno, whether or not you prefer the feel of the Xbox controller it's definitely a personal thing, but personally, it's nice. It's heavy, it's a lot bulkier, it's from more reminiscent of the old Steam controller, so this won't work into... not the old Steam controller, the original Xbox controller, which is a bit more bulky in the hand, so it probably wouldn't work well in Japan. But I don't think this is aimed at Japan. It's aimed squarely at American audience. Zornading. Hi there, Peter. Welcome. Smeagol, there's no reason why this controller couldn't drive the FEF3. If you quote my name, do they add more on? Probably. None of these scenarios are particularly long tonight, folks, so if it doesn't interest you, just wait 5 minutes. It's like the weather changing in Boston. If you don't like the weather, just wait 5 minutes. The next scenario is really good fun. It's with the GWR14XX, which is just brilliant to drive with this. It's really good fun. Curb Noob, thank you for the host. Much appreciated. Right, coming into Zonedding, I think. Where? That's the wrong button. Right. When I look over here, it's because I'm looking at the chat. I normally have it on the screen directly in front of me, but if I do that, you can see it because I'm streaming the monitor and not the game. See? Right, we're off to Egelharting. We've still got a positive score. Is there hope for us yet, do you think? This thing accelerates like a rocket. Good night, Victor. Thanks for stopping by. Tonight's viewer numbers are definitely low. Good opportunity to do something a bit different. Get back to the normal stuff on Thursday. It accelerates like a scalded cat. Oh, no, I've never done it, so I've never seen it. Alright, coming into Egelharting now. Evening, Gouger. Right. This, by the way, this works with wireless. It's got a little USB thing for doing upgrades, but in the recent updates, they actually made it to where it can do completely over-the-air updates now. So you don't really need the wire anymore, I don't think. It runs off two AA batteries. And seems to run for a long time on those two AA batteries, to be honest. That's it. And of course, because you've got the mouse, you've got access to everything going on the screen, so I can flick to the other HUD. And you can access all the functionality. You can even use the HUD, you know, the keys on the functionality on the HUD if you want to. Thanks, Ertens. It's time to zoom off. Yee-haw, good buddy. Right. Coxium. There you go. Destroying more names. coming into the next station now. Yeah, Moggy, you need to join us on Down the Mineshaft tomorrow.
See you first.
It's got to be done. You need to watch the DTM News live shows, because they're going down a storm. Everyone really enjoys those. Very different. Someone logged into it the last week. It was a new user on the stream, and all he could post on there was, "What the heck is this? This is awesome. Who did this?" Oh dear. Steam controller is so expensive. Why you say that, but it's cheaper than an Xbox controller. Xbox One controller is, I think, about 49 quid, something like that. And this is 39. So, as controllers go, it's certainly at the about right. And it's a very high powered. It's got a lot of functionality. Like I said, I'm going to go through the functionality next. We've got one more to go. Where's the next one? Graphing. Yeah, that's probably it. We lost points again. Sort of like winning points sometimes and losing points sometimes. $120, $90 living up here. B9Bot1, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. But a mouse is cheaper. Yeah, it's true. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's really whether you want the convenience of a controller, because a mouse isn't always going to be something you can use. But if a mouse is something you can use, then you're fine. But then actually, you think about it, there's certain things you can't do with a mouse. Some of the locos, like the Jinty, you can't drive with the mouse. Not unless you use the standard version. You need the keyboard to make the Jinty work. Dave, yes, it works fine under advanced locos. The next one I'm going to drive is the 14XX from Victory Works, and the Auto Coach, and drive both ends of the unit, so you can see it working just fine. And earlier on, just to make Ed feel bad, I was driving the Advanced 3F Jinty, no trouble at all with this controller. Coming up to graphing, 2 kilometres to go. Top speed's 140. What's the German language folder called? DE. Jinty isn't hard at all, not the advanced version. Just got to get used to it, that's all. Coming into graphing now. Oh, back under a minute. to make HTML accessible in general, yeah, you just put it in the DE folder, and then the game will pick it up from there if it's found. Will we get a positive score just to end on? A few extra XP in the bank. Only one or two extra XP, but it's a few extra XP. Hashtag needt.com. Right. Now. There you go. We got 147. That's not bad. Right. Let's close that. I'll wait for that noise to finish before we do anything else. We got 147 XP. Made a bit of a... you don't have to translate the message. Oh, of course you have to translate the message, BNSF. You put the German folder of content in the German folder. You still have to put the right content in there. Does the controller work okay on the 8687? Well, the Xbox controller works okay on the 8687, actually. In fact, the Xbox controller is quite good on the 8687. You just tap the throttle keys to tap up and down. It actually works very well. Okay, so, what does it actually do? What can you do with it?